Hi everyone, another Keep Talking project update, and this time we've got two more modules to explore. I have been doing a bit more programming and electronics to build Morse code and password. So I'm going to give you a run through of those right now and show you how those work and what it eventually will look like. And if, like me, you're sick of looking at a tangle of wires and breadboards, I do have a couple more videos coming on a bit more of the physical side of things, giving you a look at some of the design work and prints and builds that I've done. So if you want something a bit more aesthetically pleasing, check out the next couple of videos. But for now, we're going to be sticking with the breadboards and wires. So first up, we've got Morse code, and this is hooked up to the debugger, just so we can look at this in isolation. So let me just plug this in to give it power, and also so I can look up what the password actually is when it's generated, to save me having to actually look at the dots and dashes and figure things out from scratch. So to give you a walkthrough of the module, and I'm going to just turn this around a little bit so you have a better view of it. We've got three main parts. We've got the yellow LED here, which is the flashing Morse bulb. We have an OLED screen. This shows the currently selected frequency that has to be entered for the module. And we've got a rotary encoder here. So this is not quite like the game. I know in the past I've said that I've been trying to copy the look and feel of the game as closely as possible. So trying to use, you know, the components that make sense in terms of the game. But this is one module where I might actually diverge from the game and how the game works. So obviously with Morse, you have the blinking bulb, and you have to interpret what that word is and enter a correct frequency. And it's a bit like a radio. So you've got that old analog frequency wiper at the top, above the kind of digital readout of what the frequency is. And you've got left and right buttons to select that frequency. But it seems more like it should be an old school analog radio. So you should have a knob that lets you kind of scroll through the frequencies there. So I've gone for a rotary encoder here. I could have went for a kind of smooth potentiometer, for example, as well, which would have been another type of knob, which instead of having kind of set increments, you know, acts a bit more like an actual radio with a smooth action. But I think the rotary encoder works quite well because, again, you've got discrete frequencies that it snaps between. You don't have a kind of analog range of frequencies there. So I think that rotary encoder is a good compromise to use here. I might in future go back to the buttons like it is in the game, but for the moment it just feels right to go down this different route and use the encoder instead. But anyway, that's enough of that. Let me start the game by initializing it. And we go on to starting the game. So, unfortunately, actually, I didn't program the serial monitor to tell me what the word is for Morse code. But I could work this out if I had the manual in front of me. But this gives you an idea of how it works anyway. So you've got the blinking LED there, which you can see going off. You have the display lit up with the frequency selected, and we can change that with the encoder. So there we go, we can go through those options there. And to select, to kind of confirm your selection, there's typically a button on the module, which I'll add in the final build, final design. But in this case, the encoder does have a clicky switch, which I've hooked up, just because it's simpler to use a component that's already there. So you just simply click that in. And in that case, that was the wrong frequency, and you've got an X on the output. But you can just keep going through and pressing this until you get the right one. And actually, I've just done that by accident. So that was the correct frequency, and the lights stopped blinking because this module is solved now. So that's a nice, easy module, just a couple of components, and a reasonably easy bit of code after doing something like Simon, which has, you know, blinking lights in a sequence as well. I think the only other thing to mention is with the final build, You do have that analog frequency wiper above the digital display. That's going to be a tricky one to build. I've been looking at motors with a kind of linear action, which could push a needle backwards and forwards with a bit of coding. It seems like a detail that I don't need to tackle right now. The module works, and these are the really key parts to it. If I needed that needle, I'm going to really need to have to design the faceplate for that module first and understand, how much space I've got to work with, how long that needle track needs to be. So that's a design problem for the future that can easily be implemented as well. Anyway, that is Morse. So what I'll do is unplug this. I will unhook it from the debugger, move it off to one side, and we'll bring in the second module, which is password. So where shall I put this? It's obviously taking up a lot of room because you've got a large graphical LCD display. I think this is pretty much what they had in mind when they designed this module for the game. And I have to give credit to the to SteelCrate Games, who made the game, because I think they probably did a fair bit of research into electrical components. I think a lot of the design that they've used for the game is quite grounded in real life with real parts. So hats off to them for making this reasonably buildable, actually. But apart from obviously the big graphical display, we've got an array of 11 buttons. I did have 11 wires coming off the microcontroller and pretty much maxed out the input pins for that, but now I've gone down the route of building a very basic matrix input. So I've got a few diodes, one for each button, and that's reduced the number of wires that the microcontroller needs to read all of those buttons. But again, you've got kind of five pairs of green and red buttons, which control, moving the selected letter on the screen up and down for each of the five letters, and the yellow button on the end is the submit button. So very simple in terms of the component part there. Again, let me just hook this up to power, and also so I can read from the serial monitor what the password is, so I don't just have to scroll endlessly to try and guess that. Now I put the power in the wrong place, that's why the debugger isn't turning on. There we are. So let's initialize the game. Hopefully you can see the screen's okay. And I can see on the serial output that we have our list of letters selected with the password being thing. So let's scroll along to game start on our debugger, click that in, and we see the screen's lit up with the letters. So hopefully this is viewable. Let me just maybe change the focus for this. Maybe not. This is going to be quite difficult for you to see, unfortunately. Hopefully that's better. Yeah, okay. So you can see the screen's lit up. We've got the letters there. And what we're looking for is thing. So I can just start to scroll through the letters, pick out the right letters, which is much easier when you know what it is straight away. And we can press submit and solve this. If it's wrong, we'll get an X coming through on the debugger to say that that's been a strike. But if we put the right thing in, we actually get the inbuilt LED on the ESP lighting up and a D back. So there we go. And one thing I really like about this is that the backlight is controllable. So I've hooked that up to the ESP. So when the module turns on, the backlight comes on, telling you that this module is active. And when the game stops, the backlight goes off. So there we are. Those are two complete modules now. Really, they just need the modules designing so the components can be fit in, and we're all set to go. The next one is going to be venting gas, I think. with the Morse code that we saw earlier, that was using a green OLED screen for that. I think in the final design I'm going to be using a white screen with a kind of orange film overlay to give it that orange color like in the game. The green LED is actually going to be used for venting gas. So I can get ahead with that because that's again just the screen and a couple of buttons. And I'll be doing a lot more design work, but the design is for the next video, so you can see what I've been printing, what I've been sketching up in terms of how this is going to look and come together, and hopefully you'll be impressed with something that's looking a bit more interesting than just some breadboards and components. But that's all for today. Thanks for watching the video. If you've got any comments or feedback, please let me know. And hopefully you'll see a lot more in the next video in terms of the physical design and some of the things I've been printing. So I'll see you there.